So President Sarkisian, welcome to NATO headquarters. NATO and Armenia, we have a long-standing partnership, and I'm grateful for the contributions that Armenia has made to NATO missions and operations over the last years. During our meeting, we discussed our mission in Afghanistan, and NATO remains committed to Afghanistan's long-term security. The talks in Doha offer the best chance for peace in a generation. They must preserve the gains made over the last two decades. And I appreciate Armenia's consistent contribution to our rescue support mission in Afghanistan. We also addressed the crisis in and around Nagorno-Karabakh. I reminded the President that NATO is not part of this conflict. Both Armenia and Azerbaijan have been valued NATO partners for more than 25 years. NATO is deeply concerned by ongoing violations of the ceasefire, which have caused tragic loss of life. It is important for NATO and international security that hostilities end, the suffering stops, and a peaceful solution is found. It is vital that all sides now show restraint, observe the ceasefire, and de-escalate. Any targeting of civilians is unacceptable and must stop. All must now work towards a sustainable political solution. Armenia and Azerbaijan should resume negotiations to reach a peaceful settlement to the Nagorno-Karabakh conflict. And the efforts of the co-chairs of the OSCE Minsk group continues to be essential. So, President, welcome to the NATO headquarters. It's great to see you here, and I appreciate the exchange we had today on important issues for Armenia and for NATO. So welcome.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Secretary General. And I also would like to second your words that Armenia and NATO, they have a history of partnership, and Armenia, all of these years was behaving as a good partner. And as you mentioned yourself, we have our peacekeepers, both in Kosovo and in Afghanistan, fighting the terrorism, Islamic terrorism there. I'm here today not only to confirm that we have this several years, many years of this partnership, but also to speak with you and your colleagues here about something that concerns not only Armenia and Azerbaijan and people of Nagorno-Karabakh, but it's something which is important for the whole region. There is a statement, Mr. Secretary General, that my colleagues will distribute, but I would like to add a couple of words here. I agree with you that there cannot be any other solution to this conflict. There can be no war solution to this conflict. And we are lucky that we have the platform of OSCE Minsk Group with three co-chairs, I think United States, France, and Russia. And I appreciate all the work of all co-chairs and the presidents of all these three countries and the efforts, recent efforts of Russian Federation, President Putin and Minister Lavrov. But unfortunately, neither some 10 days ago or even today, our foreign minister was in Moscow with an anticipation of meeting the Azeri counterpart, but this meeting didn't happen, the trilateral, and we are still seeing the war continues in and around around Nagorno-Karabakh. And I agree with you, any war action and bombing of civilians is completely unacceptable. But I would like to hear, being here in NATO, to express my concerns, Mr. Secretary General, because unfortunately, a lot of analysts and those who follow the conflict in Nagorno-Karabakh and around it to, now, when it started as a war on the 27th of September, it looks like sometimes it's no longer the conflict between Republic of Artsakh or people of Nagorno-Karabakh and Azerbaijan, but there is a third party there as well that was supporting Azerbaijan both politically, diplomatically, heavily militarily, a third party that is involved in action there, a third party that that has supported and brought to the area Islamic terrorists. And unfortunately, that third party is a member of NATO. And I, being here, I could not speak about that third party, and that third party is Turkey. So I do believe that if a NATO member country like Turkey will stop being a part of the conflict and will contribute to the ceasefire and to understanding that there should be a peaceful solution, I do believe that we will reach a ceasefire there, and hopefully after that we can go back to the negotiations at the table of the Minsk group and finally find a peaceful solution to the conflict. Thank you very much again, Mr. Secretary General. And I hope that next time we meet, we'll meet in more peaceful environment, and especially in our region, not only between Nagorno-Karabakh and Azerbaijan and Armenia, because that's an important area in Caucasus and the whole region. Thank you again.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. That's all we have time for. This concludes this press point.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. I follow you.